Hi guys, welcome to next video of ServiceNow training. So in today's video we will discuss about how to define SLAs in ServiceNow for different tables. So in my previous video also I discussed about mainly according to ITIL there are three types of SLA, that is SLA, OLA and UC. So how we can define SLA, OLA and UC in ServiceNow? So in ServiceNow we don't have such different modules for all these different types of SLA. So we have a single module called SLA definition in which we define all the SLA. So how then we will differentiate these? So there is a type field called, as you can see on the list view, I opened the SLA definition. So here you can define that, okay, this is SLA, this is OLA. So this is the only identifier which is there. So now in our practical scenarios, generally for a client implementation we need to define two types of SLAs, that is resolution SLA and response SLA. So response SLA is something, once ticket created by the user and the service desk notified them, okay, we started working on this, then the response SLA got completed. So it is generally 10-15 minutes and it also depends on the agreement with the customer. Resolution SLA is one which follows the ticket life cycle. So once the ticket is created, it started, or maybe if there is a contract with client, once the acknowledgement is done, then resolution will be started. So it all depends on the contract. So generally we started once the ticket created and it completed when the ticket gets closed. Also it paused in some cases like on hold, resolved. So I will showcase all these things practically here. So I will just click on new. First I will define a response SLA for incident. So here I am taking incident table as an example. However, you can define on any table in ServiceNow. So incident response SLA. So here this is the type field I was discussing about. So you can make it as SLA, OLA or underpinning. So I am defining this as an SLA and target will be response, and then here incident table which is already there. So here you can see default SLA workflow. So this workflow is getting used for escalation purpose. Okay, let's say if your SLA is SLA time reached to 75%, then notification could be sent to the assignee that your ticket is not yet resolved and time elapsed is 75%. Then according to the contract it can go on 90% and maybe on 100%. When SLA will get breached, the manager of the assignee can be notified. So this workflow used for that purpose. You can define your custom workflow and put it here. So I will let you know how to design the workflow in next videos. So then here you can define the duration, for how many days or how many minutes or maybe hours this SLA will be. So let's say I am defining a 15 minutes of response SLA, and here you can define the schedule. So it can be 24/7 or whatever as per your client need. So you can define the schedule. So here I am saying no schedule means it will run 24/7. Now coming to start conditions. So start condition, I will put active, true and state is new. Okay, and pause condition, there won't be any pause condition okay, stop condition will be, let's say a ticket will get acknowledged, that means state would be in progress. So once the state will be in progress, the SLA will completed. So I will just save this, and now I will create one incident. So I will submit an incident here. Virus test. Here I didn't define any priority in the SLA, so it will attach for all type of priorities. So generally in real case we have priority based SLAs. So here you can see one SLA that is called incident response SLA, which we defined right now, that got started, and business time left is 14 minutes. So we defined it for 15 minutes. Now here you can see state is new. So let's say once this ticket came, service desk assigned to a group and they change the state to in progress. So here the state changed to in progress, and you can see the response SLA got completed. So now we will work on resolution SLA. So I will again go to SLA definition, and I will create one more SLA, that is incident resolution SLA. Incident resolution SLA. This will be resolution table is already there, and we can put it for, let's say, 8 hours, and schedule I will say run it for 24/7. Then again we have to define start condition, that is active is true, and let's say I'm defining it as priority based. Priority is P3. Active is true, priority is P3. Now here we will have to define the pause condition. So we can see when to cancel. So we can cancel the SLA when start conditions are not matching. So now I can pause the SLA because on hold, when it is awaiting for some use information from other resources, then SLA should got paused, and also after it is resolved. So I will say state is one of on hold and resolved. Next thing is stop condition. So stop, it will be stop in case of state is closed. Okay. So I defined it as P3 SLA. So now I will save it. Okay. And I will define, I will just put, I will define one more SLA. Here I will put P3 and just update this. Now I will define one more SLA for, let's say, P2. Okay, this will be again a resolution SLA, and this will be 16 hours. Now Now I will run it 24x7. Start condition active is true. And state, so I will put it as active is true and priority is 2, and then state is 1 of on hold or resolved. Now I will go to stop. State is closed. Now I am not defining any cancel condition, so I will say start condition not met, the SLA should cancel. So in this case, one important point we have to take care while defining, that as we said, start condition not met, then SLA will get cancelled. So throughout the life cycle of the SLA, until the state is completed, the start condition should matched. That is the reason I didn't define state in start condition, because active is true and priority is high, that is 2, will be matched on the incident ticket throughout the life cycle. If I will define here some conditions like which are not going to met until the state of the SLA got completed, SLA will get cancelled. So we have to take care here while saying that start conditions are not met, then SLA will get cancelled. We are doing this because when priority got changed, the old SLA should get cancelled and new priority SLA should get attached. Again, it is necessary to define resume condition. So as we are not defining any resume condition explicitly, so let's say once SLA started and state met resolved and SLA got stopped. Now once again, if you will put it in progress, then here we are defining when it will got resume. So here we are saying resume conditions are met, but we are not defining. So here we will define pause conditions are not met. Either we can select this option and we can define the explicit resume conditions, or we can do pause condition not match, means when the state of the incident won't be on hold and resolved, the SLA will pause. So I will save this one. Now we will go to incident and create an incident. So let's just create an incident test. So by default priority is 3, so here 2 SLA will get attached. One is 15 minute response SLA and another one is resolution SLA for P3. So it's not get attached. Let's see what happened. Oh, here you can see priority is P5. So let's just make it P3, P4. So now it is P3 and I will save it. Okay, there are few mandatory fields. So, test. I will save this. So scroll down. Now you can see incident resolution SLA for P3 is attached, which was for 8 hours, and also response SLA. So once I will assign this ticket to some group, and make the status in progress. So now response SLA will completed. You can see it here, it will completed. So one is main reporting parameter in SLAs has breached. So this is the field which indicates while reporting whether this SLA get completed or breached. So in case of response, you can see it is false, and also in case of resolution, it is false. If the SLA is not completed within 8 hours, then the resolution SLA will be has breached true. So now let's say I will change the priority to 2. Now what will happen as per the conditions we designed, we are discussing about the cancel condition and all. The P3 SLA will get cancelled and ideally it should, and the P2 SLA will start. So here you can see P3 SLA will cancelled. So it is cancelled and P2 get started. So here you can see it's 16 hours. So now let's say we will change the state to resolved. Okay. So better to change it on hold and just save this. So now our SLA will pause. So here you can see paused. So we define the resume condition as when paused conditions not match. So we will put it as maybe in progress and save this. So now it will again in progress. So it is in progress. Now if we will put it as closed and save this, so it is asking about the resolution code. Save this. So now SLA will completed. You can see here it is completed. So one more functionality for SLA is there, that is retroactive. So retroactive is something, let's say in our use case, first we put the SLA of P3, then we put the SLA of P2. So retroactive comes in picture. Let's say if you, when you change the priority and new SLA got attached, so at the time of changing priority, some time got elapsed, maybe 2-3 minutes. So if you want, the new SLA should start when it was created, then we can make use of retroactive start. So here if you will check it as retroactive start, then set to start, it is asking as, let's say we will set it as created. So here I will save it. Now let me just change the priority for this 1, 2, let's say 3. So this SLA, this incident we created in our first example. So let me just change. So as of now you can see here only response SLA is there. So now we are changing the priority to 3. So priority 3 SLA got attached. Now we will change the priority to 2. Here we define the retroactive. Test, save it. Now here we can see the retroactive start effect. So this incident we created initially when I started the video, so it's approx 14 minutes back. Now as we make the P2 as retroactive, and retroactive as created, so let me go to SLA definition. So P2, so we defined start retroactive and set start to created. So we are saying the SLA time will calculated when the ticket was created, not from when it is attached. So if we didn't define the retroactive, then SLA time will start calculating when the SLA start condition got met and SLA attached to the ticket. So as we define the retroactive, here you can see the effect. However, SLA got attached now, but you can see actual elapsed time is 14 minutes, means business elapsed time you can see as 14 minutes. That means the ticket created 15 minutes back, so SLA is taking the back time. So this is the use of retroactive start. So this is all about SLA. These are the some important concept regarding SLA. You should take care while defining the SLA. You can define SLA on any table in ServiceNow. So if you have any doubts, any queries regarding this, you can always comment. I will reply to your queries. Also, please share, subscribe and like the video. I will share next video in some time. Thank you.